been here about a month. You've been here about a month, I believe, or so.
A month, yeah.
What has the experience been like as far as bouncing around like you have the last few years and ending up here probably kind of by surprise at the time?
No, I mean, I had turned down a couple teams to stay home. Just waiting for the right opportunity. But, you know, Bears is a great organization, and they offered an opportunity for me, and I'm happy to be here. It's been great. The coaches are great. Players are great. And everybody's been very hospitable. So
when you say turn down other teams, what you mean, workouts?
Yeah, they want. Yeah, they want, you know, wanted me to come on the practice squad and you know, see how it goes, and I just wasn't willing to do that. So if I was gonna come back to football, I was gonna come and play football. So I got the opportunity to do that here, and so that's why I'm here.
Were you ready? You were ready to walk away from it, if that's kind of what happened.
Yeah, I was most definitely ready to walk away from football. I've been here 7 years now, or eight now, and done well off the field and have a business back home that's thriving. So I was willing to just stay home and run my business.
You have a card business?
Trading card business, yeah. Cash Cards Unlimited.
Yeah, how do you get into that?
I've been in since I was a young kid, since I was like 11 years old, Pokemon, Yu-Gi-Oh, and I got into Magic the Gathering, and that's kind of been my thing for a little while. And then the trading card and collectible space is skyrocketed, so I started my business like 9 months ago, and it's done well.
Good time to start a card business, right?
Great time to start a card business.
After making peace with, hey, I might be done with my football career, what has it been like to now be back on the field and having some success?
It was a mental adjustment, honestly, when I first got back. Just, you know, my mind was pretty set on staying home. You know, I was with my family and, you know, comfortable in Cali and all that good stuff. So it took some adjusting, but everybody here has been awesome, and it's been a fun experience. Great locker room, and you know, blessed to be back in ball. I love the game, you know, so it's always fun playing ball.
What was the biggest adjustment, short of probably the weather outside?
Yeah, outside of the weather, it's probably just being away from my fiance and my son.
You have an energy about yourself on the field. Where does that come from?
Probably just natural competitive nature. I was a in my younger days, I was pretty hot-headed individual and pretty reactive and stuff. I've always had some pretty explosive energy, I'd say. So, you know, in my older age, found a way to, you know, hone that and make it seem more positive, because, you know, you're referring to it in a positive manner, where typically in the past it hasn't always been that. So it's something I've learned to hone.
But you had coaches help you hone that, or self-discovery?
Probably coaches along the way too, but, you know, just self-reflection and, you know, just growing and learning from, you know, mistakes that I've made along the way in my career. So
you talked about multiple offers, so it sounds like, you know, there's still interest in you still playing. What was it that was making you get to that point where you decided that maybe it was time to walk away?
I was making a lot of money, so yeah, you know, it was money wasn't the thing that was gonna bring me back. And, you know, I love the game, and you know, I enjoy playing the game of football, and obviously money's good too. But if I was gonna come back to the game of football, I was gonna be playing in the games. You know, no disrespect to guys who are on practice squad. You know, you gotta grind and do what you gotta do to play. But it just wasn't something I was interested in at the time. So
it's coming back exactly for reasons like this week, playing Aaron Rodgers in the Packers at Lambeau Field on Sunday Night Football.
Yeah, I mean, you just I know that, you know, when it's done, and you don't get to experience these, you know, these big things like this. You know, playing against the Steelers that I had just left, and atmospheres like that. Obviously, playing against a great quarterback like Aaron Rodgers, Sunday Night Football, Lambeau, like those type of experiences will never be available to me again when I do walk away from the game. So those type of things always come into my head, and just taking advantage of the opportunities and, you know, being in the NFL is a blessing and a privilege.
Cassius, have you enjoyed your football career? I mean, there are constantly teams interested in you, but it hasn't worked out in any one particular place.
I've enjoyed it. There's been a lot of tough lessons, a lot of. It's been a journey, is what I'll say. It's definitely been a journey. It's not something that I expected. I'm a very loyal person in general, and I really buy in hard, you know. I love the people around me, and I put a lot into my day-to-day. So the first, you know, couple instances where, you know, it didn't work out and I moved around, it affected me, and I had to learn and reflect, and I think it helped me grow a lot, though. So a lot of lessons from all of the moving around, and I think it, you know, also kind of activated my mind to thinking about life after ball and, you know, business off the field, and, you know, for further developing myself as a man and a businessman, entrepreneur. So,
what are you hoping comes of this opportunity?
I'm having fun. I'm enjoying, you know, the game of football. Obviously, when you're playing ball, the objective is always to win and, you know, and get championships. I would love to have a Super Bowl under my belt. You know, I've been to one, but haven't won one. And you know, I think every player in their heart wants to win a championship. If you don't, then you're probably not in the right business. So, you know, I came here with all the expectations to help the Bears win games and. Have fun playing the game that I've loved my whole life. So,
and then the first game you play in, you've got
the talking thing happens. Mm. I imagine. I mean, did you have teammates that you didn't really know at that point? I mean, you kind of did. How did they embrace you afterwards? How did you deal with it? You had a week to go. Like, I imagine the bye week probably wasn't the most pleasurable thing in the world for you. Just how did everybody react to that, and what did you learn from it?
I got a ton of support from, honestly, I don't think anybody said anything negative to me. I don't think anybody felt like I was taunting, you know, in our locker room. And I had several players around the league and retired players who I played with in the past, guys from the Steelers, players and staff reach out and, you know, tell me that they didn't agree with the call. But it is what it is, you know what I mean? Got to respect the referees, and you know, I reflected on that incident, and you know, I'll look to do better next time I sack the quarterback. So,
you haven't faced the Packers at Lambeau as much as some of your teammates, but the last time I think you had got a pretty full dose of Aaron Rodgers. What do you recall about that, and just what does that say, just in general, about what you know, just what he can do, and the challenge you're up against when you face him, especially at Lambeau.
You know, playing Aaron Rodgers, you're going to have to come with your A game. Everybody in the league knows he's been a top quarterback for a long time. Ton of respect for the guy, and he's an amazing competitor. So I'm going to prepare and look to bring my A game. You know, that's really all you can do. You don't put too much thought into it. Don't hype yourself up. You know, football is football, but he is a great quarterback, and if you're not where you're supposed to be, then he'll make you suffer for it. So. We'll be right back.